Hi, what's your name?
Myself, Praveen Suryamurthy.
Yourself? Myself, Kirtan.
Hi, Kirtan.
Yeah, I have to ask you some questions.
Okay, please go ahead.
What's your hobby?
Enjoying nature, basically. So when it comes to nature, it is the night sky in the night time, and in the daytime, I love watching birds.
You like watching
birds? Yes, yes. I do love bird watching and all, and in the night time, and I can see the stars. And the thing is, I was always curious about the nature and what it is trying to teach us. So when I was in your age, I was actually asking questions like why sky is blue, why sun turns red in the evening, and how how far the stars are. So while asking those questions, I was able to discover things which were available in our textbooks as well as somewhere outside. So I was asking my teachers and my parents and others who are actually helping me to find the answers. But if I'm not able to find the answers, I could explore myself and find the answers. That the journey started from there. Now I am doing the same for others, where I can share my knowledge, my experiences over the years, so that everybody can learn out of the nature what we can learn out of it.
Yeah. So what have you learned in this session?
About
that.
He was a teacher, Kirtan.
Since I was an instructor, but still I learned lot many things in this session. That how people think about the stars, and how do they connect, and how do kids think like you. So when we are discussing something, you go deeper and deeper, and you ask something else which is related to that, and sometimes which is not at all related to that, but still it falls in the grand picture of things where we want to explore more stuff. So always there is a learning from the other side, that they have questions, and they have different kind of questions where sometimes we will be scratching our heads, how to answer. So obviously sometimes it is a learning experience from other side too. When they ask questions which we don't know, we will again explore about that so that we can do our job better.
Okay, wow. So this is my next question. See, I'll give you three job options.
Okay.
An astronaut, a president, or a chief minister. What would you pick?
Astronaut.
A president, I would say, but not president for the country, but president of some astronaut group.
Oh, wow.
So that I can help, reach out to people, I can gather more. If I am a single astronomer, right, I have some limitations.
Yeah.
I can do my job and may not be getting much time to do the stuff. But when I am president of some body, then again, I know how to communicate with the people. I can make use of all the scientists in our country so that they contribute to the science as well as they contribute to the public, what they are doing, and they can share their experiences. So that way, it becomes a kind of awareness for everyone. Scientists are actually doing in their labs.
It's kind of a mixture of both. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what do you think about the moon?
Moon is very important for us. If moon is not there, actually there won't be any life on there. Right. How come? Because the moon is actually helping us to stabilize, right? And also protecting us from the asteroids. You have seen those asteroids, right, which are falling on the moon. And let's say if moon is not there, definitely it will fall on the earth, right? So it is very important. For us, not only to stabilize the earth and also protecting us from the harmful asteroids that can kill us.
Yeah. What do you think about our solar system family? Except moon, obviously. Moon and earth.
It is very beautiful solar system, right? So we have a different kind of planets. Each planet is different from everything, right?
Yeah.
None of the planets are similar.
There's one comet. They are all solar system planets.
Yeah, that is common.
Yeah.
So we have a family, right?
Yeah.
We have a family, we have parents and grandparents, and we have kids and all, right? So everybody is different. Everybody's age is different. Everybody's thought process, everybody's passion, everybody's way of life, everybody's, everybody is different in their own way, right? But still they are together. Similarly, I see solar system like a family because everybody is different sizes, different, colors, and different way of, orbiting the sun, but still they are part of one entity called family. So our family should be like that.
Okay. Next question. Do you think Pluto is one of our family?
Yeah, Pluto is one of our family. But if you want to include Pluto as a planet, we have to include so many other objects as a planet.
Yeah.
So in 2006, scientists said that we have some principles to tell that, you know, this is planet. The planet has three properties mainly. One property is that it has to be spherical in shape. It would be spherical in shape only if it is bigger enough. And it has to orbit Sun in particular fashion. And third thing is, you know, when it is orbiting, it should not have any objects in its path. So, yeah, when you consider Pluto, it is satisfying first two properties, but not the third property, because it has some other objects like Charon and other objects, which are, you know, kind of asteroids and, you know, dwarf planets, which are orbiting along with that. But because it is not satisfying the third principle, it is called dwarf planet.
Can I tell you one fact about Pluto?
Yes, sure.
It takes about 260 years to complete one revolve around the Sun.
Can I tell one more fact about it?
Yeah.
Sometimes Pluto comes closer than Neptune. So it becomes eighth planet.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, yeah, every few hundred or 150 years. So right now it is ninth, but after a few years it will be eighth planet to us in terms of distance.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.